This circuit is heavily damaged and turned black. This circuit board is of a Gree Mini Split Air Conditioner 1.5 ton model. The electricity surge might have caused the circuit board to blow so badly. I have removed the circuit board from its cover. The high side of the circuit board has been damaged, which is mainly the protection circuit of this motherboard. The prints in this circuit have been severely damaged. Let's check whether its SMPS is saved or not. These components over here seem to be fine physically, but I don't know how they are internally. The microcontroller is its main component, so I will have to check whether it is safe or not. Now, I have cleaned the blackishness on the circuit board. I will show you which prints on the circuit board are disconnected on this side. I didn't clean the circuit board from the front side. The print over here has blown up. These are the prints on the low side of the board. Next, this print is blown, and next is this one. The solder mask from here has faded away. I will repair all these prints and will check all the components around these blown prints. I have removed the wire harness attached to the circuit board. Before cleaning the circuit board's front side, I will check its fuses. If these fuses are blown, then the problem will be less serious. But, if it had not blown, then the problem could have gone further in the circuit. The fuse is 25 amperes, which is the main fuse of this circuit board. The fuse is showing continuity on the multimeter, which means it is fine. Next, a fuse is mounted for the SMPS circuit, let's also check it. This fuse is also okay. I showed you that the prints on the DC side of the circuit are mostly blown up. I have cleaned the circuit board. I have removed these components from the circuit board. Because without removing this component, it was not possible to clean the circuit board. The prints here also have been blown up. This print is also blown. Also, from here, I will now check these components, which are used to drive the compressor of the inverter mini split air conditioner. I have tested the IPM, and it is fine. I have told how to check IPM in many of my videos. I will put the multimeter on diode mode, and let me check these diodes. The voltage drop is fine from this side. I will change the sides of the probes. It is fine here as well. I have placed the probes on the next diode. I will change the sides of the probes for this diode, too. It also shows a voltage drop. The IGBT are also showing the reading okay on the multimeter. The value should not be zero on these IGBT. If it shows zero reading between any pins, this means those pins are short-circuited. These IGBT are fine. I will check its rectifier now. This rectifier is only for the IPM. Because for the SMPS, another rectifier is mounted in the circuit. I have placed the probes on the positive and the negative pins of the IPM. We will get no reading on any pin. I will change the sides of the probes. Now, I will place the negative probe on the positive pin and the positive probe on the negative pin. The multimeter is now showing the voltage drop. This means the IGBT is also okay. I will now check the rectifier mounted on the back side of the circuit board because most of the prints have been blown near the rectifier. I will now check this rectifier. This rectifier shows zero voltage drop on these pins, which means it has been short-circuited. The next diode of this rectifier is fine, but the one I checked before is short-circuited. I will replace this rectifier with a new one. I have now replaced many components in the circuit board. Let me show you. I have installed a new ZNR here. Surge voltage had passed through the circuit board. DSA is mounted here. This is the capacitor to protect from the surge voltages. The line filter. The rest of the components were almost fine. This capacitor is also fine, it has only turned black. I fixed the prints that were blown by attaching wires to them. I have replaced the rectifier with a new one. An electricity surge passed through the circuit board, which caused the safety components to blow up in the circuit. I have now placed the circuit in the unit to test it. And this circuit board has been fixed. I have power on the air conditioner. The light on the circuit board has turned on. The air conditioner display has also been turned on. And see, this is the same circuit board I repaired a little while ago. You can see the wires have been attached to the circuit board. The fan motor has turned on and started to rotate. The compressor takes a little time to start. It starts almost after 30 seconds. I will wait for the compressor to start. The compressor has started now. It has started to consume amperes. I will turn it off because the pipes are not attached to the unit. I will give the unit back to the customer. Thanks to all who are supporting on Patreon, this is the list of our patrons. You can also buy me coffee on Patreon. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos. And subscribe. Thank you.